I'm Ariel Graykowski. I'm a postdoctoral fellow at the SETI Institute, and I study comets and their activity. So the full name of Comet ZTF is C2022E3 ZTF. So this comet is a comet that came all the way from the Oort cloud and very close to Earth now. Its closest approach was February 1st. And what we can see now is a bright, beautiful coma and tail. And because it's so close, we can study it very carefully and learn about how that tail and coma formed and monitor it and see if it's going to do anything crazy like an outburst or something like that. This comet is so interesting because it has gotten so close. This is sort of a typical comet that we see in our solar system, but we don't always get to see them this close. And so this is an opportunity for us to really understand what kind of materials the comet is sublimating off, what makes up the dust and the gas, and just how much of that stuff is coming off of the comet. How much mass is it shedding? We have a really good opportunity right now to do that with this comet. And this comet in particular, we're probably never going to see again. Definitely not in our lifetimes, but probably not in anybody's lifetime because it's going to leave the solar system most likely. People can see this comet with their own eyes. If they go outside within the next few days, its closest approach again was February 1st. And so soon it's not going to be so easy, but if you go outside, let your eyes adjust to the darkness, you find where the comet is in the sky using a finder chart, you should be able to see it using especially averted vision. Look just to the side of the comet. It'll help to find it first with binoculars or a telescope if you have one, but you should be able to see it with your naked eye. It'll look like a small fuzzy star. Right now, the comet can only be seen in the northern hemisphere. It's circumpolar right now. So just in the northern hemisphere, if you have a dark sky, you should be able to see it just fine. And in the coming weeks, it will move also to the southern hemisphere. So those of you down in the southern hemisphere will be able to see it very soon.